Hey y'all. Okay, I'm back to talk a little bit more about these two phones. And you know, I just want to say that I've used two phones before, but what I realized, it never lasted. And usually the reason I had two phones is because I was torn between two models. And so I would get them both. But it turned out that as I was using each one, I would be like, oh, I don't really need this one. I don't need that one. And it would be like, because they were so similar, but they were like HTC versus Samsung or something, so it would drive me crazy. But now that I have one phone for a specific purpose, it does so many things that this doesn't do, mainly because of how portable and small it is, but the performance is just not there. I mean, we'll run a quadrant. Let's see if I could do that, and you'll see what I mean. Let's see. I mean, it's like night and day, and I found out that I think that's really the best way to have two phones, is one is capable of one thing and one is capable of another, and that way you don't drive yourself crazy all day long saying, oops, you don't drive yourself crazy all day long saying, oh, do I really, I don't even know if I have Quadrant installed on this, because this phone was so kick-ass that I don't even think I ran a Quadrant. That's funny. Alright, forget that. I mean, it's about $10,000 or $12,000, and this is around $1,200 or $1,300, so you could see the difference. But anyway, some of the things I wanted to show y'all about this phone is, oh, by the way, I wanted to mention about the T-Mobile. And we're going to do a speed test right now. We're going to do both of them. And like I said, they're both running T-Mobile. And I have been very, very pleased with their, and they're both on 4G, and this, I don't know if you could see it, but there's a little H there. So begin test, and let's see what we pull. I have been so satisfied with T-Mobile, and I had them last year, and they were terrible. I couldn't even get a signal at my desk, but now this is what I consistently get every time, so no complaints. And what I did to that poster that asked me about only getting 2G on T-Mobile with an AT&T phone, that's only true if they've not refarmed the 1900 spectrum in your area, or the 2100 spectrum. I'm not 100% sure, but if you call them, which is what I did, and ask them if they had refarmed and what type of signal I should be getting, they were able to tell me that I should be getting a 3G signal on any GSM phone in my area, with both the zip codes I gave them. And it turned out they were right, because I was running, on my husband's Infuse, I was running CyanogenMod 9, and that was only pulling an edge signal, and I couldn't figure out why, because I had AT&T unlock it for me, and it turned out that ROM had 2G, used 2G signals to save battery life, always checked, and I couldn't get it unchecked no matter what I did. Kept reverting back to it, so I just put a different ROM on his phone, and now he gets 3 to 6 megabytes down consistently as well. So that's just something to think about. I don't think there's too many of y'all running CyanogenMod on Infuse on T-Mobile, but if you are, anyway, so like I said, we can put this up for now, but just so y'all know, this phone. And I've had so many phones, but I never had a phone that just worked with you like this one does. It's so fast. And we're going to, listen to the sound. Now, the speaker is behind it, so let's see how loud we can get it to be. Oh, it's on mute. As you brush your shoes, stand before your mirror. Everything is wonderful. Oh no, the speaker's up at the top. I'm pathetic. Is that the loudest it goes? Let's see. Thank you. Yep, that's the highest, but to me that's more than adequate. So that's that. I'm gonna go into the photo album. Super, super fast. That's not got a lot of pictures in that album, so let's go back. Here's my pets. Really fast. Takes nice pictures. I would say Samsung maybe takes a drop better pictures, but they're both really good. Let's see. My XM radio, Fast and Furious.
Business just in time for the unofficial start of summer.
That was pretty loud. I used Dolphin Browser on this. Did you know, and Dolphin Browser is so cool. Watch this. Let's go to Android Central. This is just a quick tip for those of y'all that don't have. Now, in Android Central, I have it set to, let's see if I could show y'all what I'm talking about. Okay, so hopefully this is a really, it's got 35 likes, probably a long post. So watch how you gotta go like this, and it could take all day because I have it set to as many posts per page as possible, right? But with Dolphin Browser, if you just go to your gestures, you make a gesture, it brings you to the top of the page. Or if you wanna get to the end of the page, you go down and it'll bring you to the bottom of the page. So how cool is that? That's just a tip if y'all don't have a Dolphin Browser, y'all need to get it. Let's exit. And let's see what else we got. The dialer. Pretty fast, pretty nice. Let's see what else. Of course, I have the multi-picture live wallpaper, which I have to have on every phone, or there's no point in getting a phone. And I'm sorry, but I don't know how some of the reviewers can say that the LG looks washed out, because I don't know if you're seeing it really as good as it is, because I have it on an angle, but the pictures are beautiful. I mean, look, here, let's go to my living room. I mean, they're just beautiful. They're vivid, they're bright, they're just gorgeous. And then just like I always have on my phones, this is how I shut it off. I never use the buttons that shut it off. And then you just put your, oops. And then you touch the proximity sensor. And look how cool. I've got it where it says, Bossy Texas Chick rocking her LG Optimus Pro. I love this phone. One of those is the owner information on my HoloLocker, and the other is the phone itself. I guess that's about it for now. I also wanted to point out, you see how my notifications are there? Everybody complains that this takes up all the notification area, but it really doesn't. I think I mentioned that in my last video, but I'm not sure if I touched on it. It really doesn't take it up, because if you leave it like this up there at the top, right there, with your settings button and all that, then the next time that you go to your notification, it's there like that. If you move it where you have the remote control there, then the next time you go to your notifications, it's where you left it. So, I mean, I don't think there's anything on this phone that LG did not think of. I have not encountered even one frustration like, oh, I miss Samsung because of this or that. The only thing that Samsung has over this, in my opinion, not one feature, is the Paper Artist, which is an app that lets you put different filters. For instance, this is one of the filters that I was able to put. I don't know if you could see it. It's a stucco oil painting with just a regular picture. You can put those filters. And so that was really nice that Samsung has. But I tried downloading it, and I actually even got it installed. I'm not sure if it's showing up. I think I deleted it, Paper Artist. But it would not open. I downloaded and I installed it, but it would not open. So hopefully that'll come to this phone. But really, everything else. Let's do a Google Now. Let's see. How do we do that? Let's try this. Let's go home. I have my home button here because I don't like touching that home button. It's too hard to touch, and I find that just as convenient. But I forget how to get... Let's try this. Domino's in Nederland, Texas. Call. Okay, that wasn't really good, but... Oh, there it is. Well, Corpus. But that was my fault. But anyway, so much for that. But really, I mean, I just wanted to make another video because in the other one, I didn't really touch on some of the things that it does. And this one, I probably did a bad example too, but you know me. Anyway, I don't know if I showed in the last video what I do just to make sure that I never, excuse me, drop this phone. I never walk around with it. And now for a guy, you probably can, but for a girl, it just, to me, I always keep this case close by, and anytime I pick it up, even to go in the next room, it's just so simple to just, you know, drop it in there, and this way, it's always got protection. And the reason that I need protection is because I'm such a klutz, and one day, I had the phone in my hand like this, and I was walking from one room to the other. This is kind of a funny story, I think, anyway. But I was walking from one room to the other, and I opened my door, and it kind of veered back, and so it almost hit me in the face because it went like that, and then it kind of swung back, and there was the door, and here was my face. And so out of reflex, I had my Note 2 at that time, out of reflex, my hand went up to stop the door from hitting me in the face, and I smashed it with my phone, and I almost died. I was afraid to look at the phone because I hit the door so hard with the phone. And luckily, not any damage. But ever since then, I was like, okay, it's too dangerous for me to even walk from room to room with the damn phone in my hand because I'm so spastic. So I got this, and I'll tell you, it's so, you know, it's perfect, and I love it. So that's it. I'll probably be doing more videos just because I cannot get over how great a phone this is. And the more that people, you know, ignore it, the more I feel like I got to get the word out there. So, but really, if you see a lot of reviewers, they don't really understand, they don't get into the, you know, how deeply you can customize it. So that to me is what makes it so great. Plus, I love that it doesn't get fingerprints on it, which is so weird. I mean, there's a little bit of fingerprints, if you could see, but nothing, you know, I don't have a screen protector on it because I don't want to lose that, you know, beautiful feel when you touch it. And it's really not mucked up at all. I mean, fingerprints usually drive me crazy. And even on the back, you know, like I said, I get that Skinomi on there. So it's just got a couple of air bubbles that need to work themselves out. But as far as fingerprints, nothing like you see when you don't have that on. So pretty cool. Anyway, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed. And as I said in my last video, be kind in the comments. Either say nothing at all or something nice. Thanks. Bye.